start with our points of champions. Start with our classics. Third place is Cameron Skinner. I don't think he's here. So next one, second place, Robbie Sands. Okay, what about our winner then, Mr. Marvin Ray?
I guess since none of the others showed up, I get all three trophies tonight. Got a lot of people to thank for getting me here. Some are here tonight, some aren't. A few of them have passed on. Just want to say thank you to everybody. Lester Calvin, thank you for your sacrifice, your hard work, the opportunity to be up here on this stage. Thank you. Thank you for giving me that opportunity.
I want to say something real great about Marvin. He's a terrific race car driver to work with. Mitch and I really appreciate him. You know, he did all the little bikes for the children this year, a few donated bikes and everything. That was just really special, and really do appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, we're going to do something a little different. We're going back and forth. We've got a hard charger award. This driver, everybody watches and knows how a hard charger is. And one thing about this driver is, as hard as he races and as much as he races, every week when he comes to the track, the car looked like it's never been raced. He's got beautiful cars. He's got some little specials on it and everything, and people love to watch this car go around the track. Our hard charger award for this year is to the number 71, David Miley.
Another thing about David, he was we had him in the list of several different things he could have won here tonight. So he's a great, great race car driver, and he could have been, like I said, three or four different things, and we had to just choose one. So congratulations. Okay, now to the mini stop. Third place, Mike Townsend.
I'd just like to thank all my sponsors and stuff. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be able to race this year. And just want to thank my wife and my daughter for putting up with me all year, because I've put in a lot of long hours. Just thank everybody that took a part in it. Just
thank you, Mike. And second place, Tommy Mettler.
I'd like to thank everybody from the original Friezo, Darrell Dalton and Barbara Cosby. And I'd like to thank my wife, Sandra, and my son, Kenneth. And we'll be back racing again next year. Thank y'all very much.
And the first place is, of course, Mr. Rocky McNabb. Couldn't say enough about Rocky. He's done everything. He's done Food City Race Night, most best race car driver to work with on anything. He's always very nice and supportive and really great.
Thank you. I had a few people ask me how long I was going to let me grow my beard out, but you'll have to ask Joe Bird about that. He's contracted me to grow a 2014 toupee. Kidding, Joe. I got to get you every year. No, I need to thank a few people. First, Mitch, Tanya, and the whole crew at 411. We love going 411, and they do a good job. All the employees and volunteers. We couldn't do it without you, and it's just good. I got a lot of family support. My dad, mom, Don and Blue, my sister, Dean and Jackie, girlfriend Mallory, y'all know her. I couldn't do it without them. You gotta have a good family support. This is definitely a family sport altogether, and I couldn't do it. The competitors, Tommy, Mike, you guys put on a good show this year. I'm glad we had some good races, some good battles. And y'all watch out for Mike, he's coming on. my sponsors, of course, my dad, McNabb Roofing. Dad's kind of semi-retired from the track now, but he works just as hard all week. And I think all you know, Monday through Friday is what wins you on Saturday. And I got to thank him for that. Ace Transmissions, James. James Needham, he's a good sponsor. He come on this year and helped us out. They're on Clinton Highway. You got any automotive needs, go check them out. B&R Race Engines, Bill and Ron, the whole gang there, they keep us running all year. Keep the motors freshed up, and some good horsepower. Some of y'all saw that. Ron, especially, he's there almost every week helping us on the car. There's a lot of times we couldn't have made the feature without Ron. White Lightning Bodies, Ross and the whole family there, they keep us good and straight, and I help bend that up for them. Keep us looking good, though, and speaking of which about time for a new one, I do believe. Full Moon Graphics in Athens. I told him about the Days of Thunder theme. He went right with it and nailed it, I think. So I got to thank him for that. Wells Racing Photography, he does a good job. And there's a ton of others I could list on, and it goes on and on. And I just got to thank everybody. Appreciate it.
Our next award is the Most Improved Driver Award. You know, there are a lot of times guys, they come out and they start racing and they improve, they get a little better, and their buddies brag on them or their parents brag on them or something like that. But I think it means a lot when the track brags on you. And this driver showed a lot of improvement this year. He got faster, better, and I think all you guys that race with him know that he's going to be a driver you can race with and trust. So our most improved driver for 2013, 31 weight model, Brad Siegel.
Okay, moving on to modified. Third place, Kevin Lewis.
Well, 2013 was a pretty good season. I would like to start off by thanking my dad, Mike Lewis, my crew chief, Sammy Johnson, Roger Hall, and I'd really like to thank Johnny Ridens. It's been a good, hard racing season. And I'd really like to thank the McCarters for keeping our class and letting us run. But 2013, it was fun. Can't wait for this year.
Okay, second place, Shane Taylor.
most of all, I'd like to thank my brother Jacob, Nathan. We spent a lot of long nights in the garage. Also thank Mike, and all Lewis, Johnny Ridings, all them for all the help. I mean, the modified class, I know that one night in the heat race I got beat and banged up, and I had like three different drivers out of that class come and need, see if I need any parts to finish the race. So, thank my wife, and Nathan's wife, for letting him help me. Because without them, I mean, there's a lot of times I wouldn't be there, which I probably won't be there as much this year. Most of you know we got a newborn baby. So thank you all.
And our winner is Johnny Ridings. One thing I'm going to say about Johnny, every time I've ever seen him at 411, he's always smiles and always the nicest man, no matter what's happened in the night, if it's been a good night for him or a bad night, he's always smiling and leaves such a good, makes you feel so good.
First off, I'd like to say thank you to the McCarters and their family for giving us an opportunity to race at our racetrack. It's an awesome facility. Thank them for giving us a place to keep the modifieds to run this year. It's been an exciting season. It's been a lot of hard work. A lot of people know it. If they run for points, it's a lot of dedication and determination. It takes it to do it. I'd like to thank my sponsors. First off, East Tennessee Pavement Services, Richard and Craig Maynard. They do all they can for me. Next up, T&N Machine Shop and Race Engines, Tommy Newton and Ron. Awesome engines, awesome horsepower. Year before, we had blown motors left and right. And I finally gave up and I called Tommy and I said, "Hey, Tommy," I said, "man, I need some help." He said, "Bring it up here, we'll fix it." Awesome, awesome service. We ran 29 races with this motor without a problem. If anybody has any questions about motors or whatever, go to Tommy. He'll help you. Ron, awesome guys to work with. O'Reilly Auto Parts, Jackie Stennett, awesome. Awesome service from him. If I needed something, he'd just say, "Call me. Whatever you need." Wildwood Farm, Julie over there, she's helped me a lot with fuel and stuff this year. I'd like to thank her. JT Kerr Racing Equipment. I know he's sort of under the weather right now, but I want to thank him for everything he's done for me. Sort of tore the car up at the beginning of the year and took it over, and within a day or so they had it fixed and went and picked it up and raced the next week, so can't complain about them. Outlaw Graphics out of Crossville, Tennessee, Joe Klein. Awesome guy, does great graphics work. He's done mine for the last 2 or 3 years. Awesome looking graphics. Perfection Plus Painting, Mike Lewis, thank you for everything you've done for me this year. Awesome sportsmanship from you and Kevin, Shane. Just a great group of guys to race with in the modified division, without a doubt. Wouldn't have it any other way. I also like to thank Dave Lewis, Mike's brother. He's helped me out. P&D Car Audio and Detailing. Like to thank them. Mini Me Graphics, Alex. He's done some window stickers and stuff for me. Decent looking stickers, so I thank him for it. Like to thank my family for sticking with me through this. Back some years ago, I ran for points in what they called Pro Street then, down at Smoky Mountain. And my dad always told me, he said, "Son, you can do anything you want to as long as you give it determination and dedication. Give it all you've got." Thanks to him, I had that determination and dedication this year. It took a lot from me and my family. And sometimes you got to do what you got to do. It was worth it. It's tough. but I want to thank every fan that comes to the racetrack every weekend. That means a lot to me, because without you guys, there's no way we could do this. No way in this world, because we wouldn't have a place to race. Tanya and Mitch wouldn't have a reason to have the racetrack open. But again, thank you, everybody.
All right. Our next award. This is probably not an award that anybody wants to have. It's not got a very good name. And it means that you had a lot of bad luck. But we wanted to recognize somebody for this award that came to 411. He had all kinds of troubles. I believe he had more flat tires than anybody. Wrecks. But he stayed with us. He kept coming back. So we wanted to recognize him, because he did have a lot of bad luck. And over the years that I've been around him, I've dropped a lot of checkered flags over this guy. So I knew what he could do, and it was just seeing him up there this year and not being able to get the checkered flags like he used to was kind of different. But we appreciate him supporting 411 and being with us. We wanted to recognize him. So our Hard Luck Award driver goes to the J3 of Jeff McLemore.
Okay, now to street stock. Third place, Scotty Atkins.
I ain't got much to say. I want to thank Robbie and them, Dad and Mom, and my little boy and my little nephew, and NMA Press for sometimes.
Second place, Dale Watson. And our winner, champion, is David Price. Sounds pretty popular.
Well, I'd like to start off by thanking everybody who comes and races for us. I got a lot of people I'd like to thank tonight, but I can't think of all of them, so I'm going to do my best. I'd like to thank my mom, my family who come here every week to watch me race. Thank my wife for putting up with me. And the Stennis for putting up with me. All right, and most of all, I'd like to thank Jackie Stennis from O'Reilly's. If it wasn't for him, my car would not be at the racetrack every week. And Ronnie Bibbins, he's another one. If it wasn't for him, I would not be at the racetrack every week. Them two men are behind me every step I take, and they put my car on the track every week, and I cannot do it without them. I'd like to give a big thanks to you all.
Okay.
All right, our next award. I'm not going to say a lot about this. It's a winning spirit award, and we're trying to really think what that really means, and it can mean a lot of things, but as far as the driver that's taking this award home, if you watch him every week, he's a pleasure to work with. He tries hard. He's got the spirit in him. He's a good, clean driver, and it's enjoyable working with a driver like him. So for the Winning Spirit Award this year goes to the number 37, Modified Shane Taylor.
Okay, our next class, Thunder and Lightning. Third place, David Miley.
I really don't have anybody think I did this all by myself. No, I really, none of them's here, but congratulations, Robbie, Rocky. Thanks, everybody.
Second place, Rocky Ogle.
Thank you. I'd like to thank the McCarter family for providing this facility for us. I'd like to thank the track officials for all they do. I'd like to thank the volunteer rescue squad for having our back. Okay. Rick Ogle, my pit crew, I don't know why you stay with me, but he was at every race this year. That's great. Thank you very much. Okay. Wendell Spence was a great help to us. I'd like to thank Robbie Comer for everything he does. No matter what I tear up, he's standing there ready to fix it when I get in the pits. But thank you very much.
Okay, and our winner. Before I say this, let's see. Is he, let's see, five, six? How many times is it, Robbie? Six. Told him last year he's got pretty much a closet full of jackets and things like that. And, you know, we were kind of joking at first. And he said something maybe about a driving suit or something. And I said, well, I tell you what, if you can win one more year and make it your sixth time, I'll get you a driving suit. So guess what? He won. He's got himself a driving suit. Robbie Comer.
I just like to thank God first, because without him, it wouldn't be possible for me to get out here. So I got to start where it starts at, the reason that I go race every week. And then my wife for being patient, and my mom for taking me to the races way, way, way back when I was just a little fella, about the size of my son now. And my crew chief, Robbie Gibbs, which is not here tonight. I wished he was. And I've got a lot of sponsors, Robbins Heating and Cooling, Clinton Pallet. Anytime that I need anything, I can call on them, and they're there for me. Maynard's Auto Parts out of La Follette, they're there for me. And my dad, even though he don't come to the track, he be sure I've got what I need when I get there to the track every Saturday night, and I got to thank him. And we're going to try our hand at something a little bit different this coming season, do a couple of different things and see how that goes for a while. I feel like God's leading me in that position right now because he's opened up a lot of doors to make that possible. And I thank God for that. So everybody just keep praying and keep their faith with God, and that's where it's at. And thank you, everybody.
All right, our next award is called the Man on the Move Award. And this feller is on the move. He showed promise from the time he got there, but every week you can watch him, he's getting better and faster and better and faster. So you guys in Thunder and Light are going to have to watch out because he's coming that way. The Man on the Move Award for this year is the number 14, David Kerr.
Say something about this young guy. He's just a sweet. And when we were talking about this award, it's like he really was on the move. He was always right there. That class is just, you know, all this competition, but he was always right there, just that close, just a heck of a race car driver. This next award we're going to do before we do the limited late models, we're going to do the Rookie of the Year Award.
Uh, 2013 was a good year for this young driver. When kind of the way that we do these special awards, there's myself and Tanya and Joe and probably six or seven of us, we'll talk about it, and the same name kept popping up for this, and this young man has grew as a race car driver and as a person this year. And I wanted to do this because I'm especially proud of him. I've probably talked to him, not that I don't talk to everybody, but I've probably talked to him more this season than any of the other drivers, probably because he would come up and talk to me. It seems like some other people won't even, they're scared to say anything to me or afraid that I'm going to say something or whatever, but this young man, he and I struck a friendship, and I think a lot of him, not that I don't think a lot of everybody. I just, I wanted to do this award myself, but the 2013 Rookie of the Year is Brandon Gardner. Before we do the late model awards, something that we can't forget, people that help us, 411 Motor Speedway, financially, and Tennessee Booze It and Lose It, and I may butcher this name, Madeira Windows, I'm sorry. HVH, High Velocity Heads, I think a lot of racers use them. They're good people. Mighty Muffler, Ricky and Teresa Grubb, Speedway Market down below us, Walker's Collision Repair, You Junked It, West Haven, Old Smoky Moonshine, which is here in Gatlinburg, TennesseeRacer.com, Tennessee RV, Roger Sellers, which everybody knows. Roger's a partner in Smoky Mountain Speedway. They're good people. Bobcat of Knoxville, Snappy Tomato Pizza, Tennessee State Bank, JT Kerr Racing Equipment, and McCarter Lumber Company. We appreciate all those sponsors, and hopefully if you all ever need any products that these people sell, you'll give them some business. Now, are we ready? You got another one? Okay, Mark, here you go.
Mitch didn't know it. We got more awards than we do classes, so we had to come up with something. All right, I've got two more, real quick, but they're important. This is a sportsmanship award. And this driver, I've known him a long time. I've worked with him a lot. And I'm not taking away from any of the rest of you. I think all of you are great. That's one reason I love working up there, is because of the people we got. But this driver is nice to work with. If he's got a problem, he comes to you. We can talk it over. We can work it out. And he's just a pleasure to be around every week. So our sportsmanship award for this year is the number 29, Mike Townsend. I hate to tell you this, we're going to have to change that. He's a bad sport. He won't talk. All right, we got one more till we get to the biggie. You know, we've got all these awards for all these drivers, and every year we have awards for drivers. And that's the way it's always been. But me and Tandy were talking a few weeks ago, and she was saying, you know, can you think anything? And so we kicked stuff around. And we thought we'd like to start something that would be not just for a driver. It might be for a fan or a car owner or a sponsor or a family that's in racing with us. So we got to thinking, and we talked about different ones. And one thing I could think of would be somebody that just about included everything we think about. They are fans, and they bring fans. They're a team. They're a family. They're a car owner. They have multiple cars. They can bring a car for any class if they wanted to. So this year's Lifetime Achievement Award, and two of the main ones, well, I'm not going to say main ones. One of the main ones is sitting here, so I'll go give it to her. But the other two are in Charlotte at a racing auction, and that's what they do all the time. They got off their heavy equipment the other day, and they took off to Charlotte to buy parts to race at 411. So this year's Lifetime Achievement Award is for the entire Watson family, James and Dale Watson and all of their family. We appreciate you all.
Okay, now it's limited late model time. And after this is over, we do still have a few more presentation awards to give out for sponsors and things like that, and probably a little bit more trivia, and I don't know what else I'll figure out. Third place in late models is Brandon Garner.
I want to thank my papa for giving me my start, and all my family for supporting me.
Second place, Brad Siegel.
I'd like to thank all my sponsors and Roger and Cindy Kerr and Josh and Nathan on the crew and Charlie, my mom and dad, and thank all you fans for showing up every week. Thank you.
And our winner for the limited late models, have you got butterflies?
Yeah.
Good. I enjoy watching him race more and more all the time. Every time I watch, he's just always just, I don't know, I don't know how to explain it. I always just laid back, smiling, and happy-go-lucky. And he's actually helped me out a few times in the ticket booth and different things like that. And what a great guy, Rusty Ballinger.
First, I'd like to thank Tanya and Mitch McCarter, all the fans, and all the other drivers that won it this year. It's pretty hard to win a championship. All the infield volunteers, every time we're wrecking, I remember one night I wrecked, and right when I wrecked, that kid was right there, seeing if we're all right. All my family, Tommy Newton and Ron with 10N Race Engines, they helped me all the time at the house. Great motor, it lasted all year. HVH, Brian King, we had one small motor problem, he helped me for 2 weeks, and my crew, Tim, Jay, Dad, Matt Griffith, and we got two surprises here. If Johnny come up here. Then we need Dad, Tommy, and Ron up here.
Okay, me and Rusty has come up with something for our engine builder and his help here in recognition of the service we've had this year. Awesome, like I said a while ago, it's awesome motors, and we want to thank you guys for what y'all have done for us and hope the relationship continues on.
And the next surprise is me and Dad, we kind of have this little argument at home about the trophy, because he wants it at his house, I want it at my house now, and so we made him one just for him. His trophy.
Hold on.
We got to find it. So now there's no more arguing. He's got one too.
This was kind of a surprise. This award here is an award of excellence. And it's kind of from all of us and Mitch. It goes from the top down to the bottom. All of us at 411 Motor Speedway. And this is really from the fans and the drivers and the crews and the workers and the emergency people and everybody that's connected with 411 Motor Speedway, because we couldn't do it, Mitch couldn't do it, none of us could do this and put this on every week without this beautiful young lady. So our award of excellence goes to Tanya McCarter, who we all love, and she's a doll. This is for you. We love you, and we love working with you. Now she can't talk. Well, she can't talk now. I've got her tore up. No more door prizes.
Thank you very much. I sure didn't expect that. And now I totally forgot what I was going to say at the very beginning, so y'all have to be patient with me for a second. First thing I do want to say is Food City Race Night's coming out. It's going to be March the 13th, 2014. And if any of you all, we like to have these drivers participate in this, because it's so neat to see the fans come out and the little kids come up and see their favorite driver. And it's just it's a really good, fun night event. And if anybody be interested in doing it this year with us, if you'd go see Angie King here tonight, we'll go ahead and put your name down and get everything started, the paperwork with Food City. So I'd really appreciate that. First thing what I want to say, I want to thank everybody that works for us. It's, you know, when we first got a racetrack, I had no idea what all it consisted of at all. And it's pretty much full-time, year-round, you know, because you're trying in the off-season to get things prepared for the season. Like right now, we're working on getting new sponsors and things like that. Getting ready to have a race in February, the Sweetheart Race. And we kicked off that last year in memory of Scott Sexton. But I want to really thank it's everybody all combined, you know, doing this, like the score people, Joe and Kelly Bird, Mark and Sam, Mark Bells and Jan, the photographers, Carol and Jamie, couldn't say enough about them, did great photography work. Now here I go, I'm probably going to start forgetting people, so it's going to pop up, I know. Angie King for all the special events she helps me with, all this helping today. Today was, I'll tell you what, I couldn't do anything today without these ladies that helped me today. Angie King, Susie and Danny Yoder, Mark and Sam, Joe and Kelly. Christy Gallion, that's coming, but see, they're up here telling me what to say, too. I'll go home tonight and realize I probably should have said 10 more things. Christy Gallion. And also the concession stand workers there at the racetrack. You know, that takes a lot of time. It's all day getting up, going Friday and getting everything, working all day Saturday. You know, it takes a lot of time. We try to have an excellent concession stand, and I believe in my heart it really is. Couldn't say enough about Brian Morlock. He does just amazing work. I call him all the time last minute. Brian, I need this. Brian, you know, he does great trophy work, great graphic work, every details. Thank you, Brian. I really appreciate it. Track officials, couldn't do it without you. You know, on Saturday night, if people heard us on the radio sometimes, they'd probably get a little kick out of us all the time trying to talk at one time. Then we don't really know what's going on sometimes, but yeah, we just hang in there and we work excellent together, and that's the way it really works great. The rescue workers, you're in great hands with them. They're right there, as I call them, Johnny on the spot. And as you know, this year we've had a few instances with fires last year with Johnny Ridings, fires this year. A lot of things happen, and you know, we've handled it very well, took great care of it, and you learn from that. Now, who have I forgot that helped me today? Okay, I'm thinking. But we really do appreciate everybody there that does help with everything. And but like I said, think about Food City Race Night. And thank you for these wives that let their husbands race, because it is a full-time job, you know, getting these cars ready. And you ask, why are they in the garage till 12 or 1 o'clock at the night? But they really are working. It's a job, you know, but it's a fun job. And but I really do. We do appreciate you and thank you. And now we're going to do a few more trivias, get a little more. Maybe somebody can get a pit pass. Be pretty neat. And we've got somebody wants to make an announcement, Miss Carol Comer. This lady's a sweet, precious lady, friend of mine. Now she's going to start crying, get me tore up.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank Tanya and Mitch for giving me and Jamie the opportunity to be able to go out and take the pictures that we take. And everybody there at that track, you've come really, really dear to my heart. And it's with a sad heart, but a happy heart too, that I'd like, Jamie and I are going to give up the photography this year, because Robbie has had the opportunity to move on to bigger things. And as a mother, I'm very, very proud of him. And I'm so thankful that the Lord seemed fit to let him go that way, because he works really, really hard. But I'm really going to miss everybody. You know, you're my family. And I really want to thank all of you for the support you've given us through the years. I mean, I've got to know each and every one of you personally, and it's just really, really, you've mean a lot to us, because you are our racing family. And we just want to thank you for everything you've done for us.
And I told you I was going to forget something. The Little Miss Four-Limb Princesses, those little sweet girls every Saturday, they're just as sweet as they can be, and I so much appreciate all their little cute smiles on their face and going around to different drivers and fans, and they're just cute, and I couldn't do without them. Haley Stennett, Nikki Morgan, and Lacey Carville.
Okay, let's see if we can't give a pit pass away. Hey, is this the only questions? Wasn't there some more? Try to find a good one. Okay, this first one will be for a pit pass for one night. This one's kind of easy. When is the first points race for the 2014 race season? Raise your hand. First points race for the 2014 race season. The date. Got to have the date, not just... Miss Keisha? April 5th, that's correct.